All right, if you're using Microsoft Excel, you may be finding yourself in a situation where you don't want to be able to enter values into certain cells based on the values of other cells. So a good example of this could be, say, a shipping record. So I made one here, and let's say someone comes in after something is shipped and they type in a tracking number. So for example, if this puzzle on May 17th was shipped, you would come in here, put in a tracking number and hit enter. All's fine with that, right? But if it's not shipped yet, you accidentally put this on the wrong line, so the shipping status of this item is pending. What would be nice is when the person presses enter, it doesn't allow you to input it. So you can do that, and it's only a couple of steps, and we'll go through a few different scenarios because everyone's spreadsheet is different, right? It's not going to be exactly like this. But let's do the most straightforward first. So let's say we're trying to protect the range E3 through E18 from getting a tracking number entered unless the shipping status is shipped. Okay, so the first thing that you do is just select that range and go to the data ribbon, and we'll use data validation. Left click here. And the data validation box comes up, and it starts with the validation criteria of any value. So that's essentially turned off. So of course, what you're going to want to do is change that. Let's left click on this drop down box, and we're going to just use a custom formula. So left click on that, and then you get this box here that's waiting for your formula. We're going to write a formula that says, hey, is the value in D3 equal shipped? If it does, that's okay. Otherwise, reject the input. So we'll start the formula out with an equal sign. And when you write a custom formula for data validation, you write it as if it's in the top left-hand side of the range that you're working with. This range is only one cell wide, so it's just the top value. But we're going to look for the top value, and we're checking that is going to be D3. We just want to see if it's equal to shipped. If it is, the rule validates and you can enter your data. So left click on OK. And then we'll act as if we're going to come in here and accidentally enter a tracking number for something that's pending. Hit enter, and it won't allow you. It says it doesn't match the validation criteria. And that's the most basic level, and we're just going to expand this a little bit and then talk about some different options. So let's say we wanted to apply this to more than one column. So you have to do the formula a little bit differently. So the first thing that we'll do, we'll go clear out that rule. So we'll left click on validation, select clear all, and click OK. And now go back and grab this range. Click on data validation. So let's keep in mind here, we're still going to do a custom formula. But whether or not we're evaluating the data in column E or F, we're still going to want to look at column D. So when you write the custom formula for this, the only change is going to be you want to put a dollar sign before the column reference of D, and then that tells Excel, always look at D. So when you go into column F, which is called shipping service, don't shift over and look at column E, stay in D. And we'll do the same row. And we'll say equal to shipped. We'll click OK, and then this rule should apply to both. So let's say it's pending, and you go in here and start, and you just type FedEx Ground. Hit enter, it won't let you do it. All right, so we've covered both of these columns. The next scenario that we're going to look at, let's go to this other worksheet. All right, so for this spreadsheet, we'll control this entire range just based on the value of this dropdown. So we use data validation in F3 to create a dropdown. It doesn't need to be a dropdown. I just thought it looked a little bit nicer. And it has open or closed. So let's select B3. Through D14, we'll come back up data validation, and all we're doing is looking at the status of F3. So we'll make another custom rule, and we will say, we'll start it with an equal sign as always. Here we're going to lock both the column reference and the row reference. So that's two differences from where we started. And we'll say equal to open. So if it passes this rule, then you can use the table. If not, it won't work. So So if I change it from open to close, you already see that it's giving you a data validation error in D3, but that was already in there. So let's try another one. We'll just put a 5 in D5 and we get the data validation error. So you aren't able to enter anything into this table unless you go back up to the drop-down box and you open it again. There we go. So before you apply this rule, let's just make sure that it makes sense for your situation. So an alternative to doing data validation is, let's just turn this off. We'll say clear all. Is that when you come in here, you may just want to apply a filter. So we'll left click on this filter. Since this is formatted as a table, I have the filters at the top and just only show shipped. And then when you come in and show shipped, then you can enter these tracking numbers and the shipping service, and you won't accidentally apply it to something else because you can't see them. And then when you're done, you can just take the text filter off. All right, so just choose which one worked best for you, right? So here's a collection of other Excel videos. If you like this video, there's a lot of other videos on this channel that are really similar to this, just little tips and tricks. And I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.